Hello everybody and welcome back to Nobody Dwells playthrough of Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition. Today we're going to the depths and we're going to fucking kill the gaping dragon. I promise you. We're gonna do that. And I'd just like to remind you, I'm making somewhat similar, very similar to the character that I first made on my very first playthrough of the game. But, not exactly I believe the very first time I played through this game, I didn't realize that you could talk to the undead merchant in the burg, who dropped this katana. So I killed him and I got the katana. I was like, ooh, I didn't know there was katanas in this game. I was already making a sorcerer character. I know I'm a filthy casual, but then I made, and I kind of transferred over to a katana while keeping sorcery and using sorcery to, enhance the katana-ing. And, then I killed Sif, got his soul, and then I used the Great Shield of Artorias. So that requires a lot of strength, so... believe like 38, maybe it's 32. I can't entirely remember, but it's something around there. Which we want to get the washing pole, because the washing pole has dexterity and strength scaling, and it's still a katana, and it has a longer reach. But it does break easier. It does have a easier grip. It has lower durability. So we just gotta be careful about that. I'm trying to see. Okay. Shit. Well. I was kind of delaying that second. That second hit. Alright. Oh, shit. I'm just gonna run up and get these souls. Oh, I was trying to get that backstab. We're just gonna kinda... Oh, right there. Alright, good. And, these characters are actually women. I think I talked about that in the last episode. We got the large ember. And pretty much that allows us to reinforce our weapon past plus 5. Using, I believe, large titanite shards. We gotta go save a certain character first before we move on, though. Brandy, oh shit, I forgot my attacks always fucking hit the top and get all fucked up. kind of before we fight any more enemies scratching my head. No, there's a person right up there. Actually, I think we can target. Yeah. It is kind of a strategic position by FromSoft. It's not a lot of people just look up and see if there's an enemy or not, honestly. Oh, shit, I didn't realize it was going to go through the wall. We got a sack here. Looking fucking swaggin'.
You. Yes, you. Here, over here. Please, you must help me. Thank you. I would have been a sucker without you. Beginning alive, I started to think. Thank you. Thank you, dearly. I am Laurentius, Lord the Great Swamp. I will not forget my debt to you. Oh, hello there. I'm fine, thanks to you.
So pretty much this is Laurentius. He's a pyromancer, and he will be available once we get back to Firelink Shrine, which won't be for a little while, to be honest, guys. I'm just gonna tell you now. We're probably going to be in Blight Town for a little while. There's a shortcut here, and we just pop right down here. There's an item right over here, a very good item for this area and for Blight Town. Spider shield. And it resists poison pretty fucking good, to be honest. And it blocks 100% physical damage, so I don't think it has very good stability. Well, it has 56 stability, which is the same as... There's this giant rat, so we're just going to cheese a few spells onto him. And then we're just going to end his fucking existence right there and get humanity. Then we can safely get all these treasures. Now, be careful when you're sliding down here. Be on the left wall and just keep pressing towards the left wall, and you'll make it. Otherwise, you're gonna go right down and fall to your death. These fucking things are assholes. I hate them. These fucking slime ass motherfuckers. Those are rat. So if we go up these stairs, and this door can only be opened by this side, from this side. So if you're on the other side of this door, you're fucked. You have to go around. Oh shit, I don't want to die right here. Oh, I hate these fucking torch hollows, thank god. So that key. And there's a bonfire! Da 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 da! A little bit. I think we're gonna go and start leveling up our vitality because we have fucking none. Do we have any? We do. I don't know if we'll be able to level up though. God damn it. Oh, okay. We're just a little bit off, so we'll just kill this enemy a few times, I think. And actually, we're gonna kindle our bonfire here. And actually, we need these souls to buy a certain thing. So we're gonna kindle. So, we're not going to run directly to the boss right now, but what we are going to do is that we're going to make a fine trade. We're going to make a fine trade. Right here is the way to Blighttown, and it's locked. We need to get the key.
Aye, Shemari, and good day to you. I'm Dawn of Xena. I'm just a peddler of sorts. I adore trinkets and oddities, so I trade for them. I'm afraid I don't...
Yeah, you just trade stuff. You can get his armor. Personally, I don't like it. It does look cool, but the actual stats and abilities of it, I personally don't like it. We're gonna need this gold pine resin.
Thank you. That was a fine trade. I have this funny feeling we'll meet again soon. We'll make another fine trade, of course.
Of course. Another fine trade. Why wouldn't we? We need to get large titanite shards, and I can't remember exactly. I believe in Blighttown there's these slugs that drop them. They also drop green titanite shards. Which I believe are used for divine reinforcement and magical reinforcement. But I just want to get the weapon raw. Raw plus 15. Special attributes, you know. I meant plus 10. I'm sorry, I'm stupid. I couldn't remember. This little BB rat ran away. Alright. We're gonna... Right here... This is our first... This is normally player's first invasion. It's with Knight Kirk. Oh, shit. He can do damage to you while he's rolling. And I forgot to equip a shield. Oh shit, I'm not trying to die to him. I want to get his armor, so I'm not trying to die to him. This is actually pretty interesting character if you do pay attention to where he invades you and where his corpse ends up. It is actually pretty interesting if you ask me. Oh shit. These little frog things, when they spit out their fire shit, they actually can curse you, and you need to go and get your curse removed. Now, Kirk dropped the barbed straight sword. It actually has the same effect as the Uchi Katana with bleeding, right down here. This is bleeding. But personally, I don't like it. If you like straight swords, you might like it. But it doesn't have any. I believe it's just. Oh, it apparently does have a thrust. I don't know. Please. I'm not seeing it, but yeah, I just don't like the moveset personally. Sure, like if you upgrade it, it's really good, but any weapon can become really good if you just upgrade it. Need to get over there. A really good item to have in the depths is the curse bite ring. And pretty much what it does is that it just increases your resistance to curses. So we got an eye of death here. Which is a Gravelord Covenant item. So if you're in the Gravelord Covenant, good place to farm them. I don't want to get cursed right now, so let's run by here. Gonna jump down here and kill whatever one's left. Oh shit, I just ran right into the cloud. See, this is a good time to actually have, like, ranged. Oh, he spit it out too fucking late. God, it was too late. Oh, okay, just cleared up. You got another Eye of Death. There's just a bunch of them right here. New players will be cursed. Like, I'm just saying. Okay, so. Never mind, I'm sorry. I had a brain fart. I'm sorry. I apologize. So we want to go down here. Just gonna run over here. And we have the Ring of the Evil Eye. And we absorb health from killed enemies. I believe it's 30 points of health per killed enemy. It could be more or less, but yeah. Fairly useful when you're using if you're one-shotting enemies with the Chaos Blade, which takes away your health a little bit on each hit. If you're one-shotting enemies, it'll pretty much it negates that effect on it. So it's not really useful for PvP. But it is useful early on, when you don't have a lot of health, like me. But you could totally be completely leveled up with health right now, but just not level up anything else. I'm losing track of where I'm going right now, I'm sorry. I remember. That's pretty much what we came down here for. right now. We're back here. And, I believe there's another way to go. Perhaps I'm wrong. That's the way to the boss. Yeah, maybe I'm wrong about that. So we're just gonna rest at the bonfire, level up, and then we're gonna go and fight the gaping dragon then. Oh wait, yeah, that's right, I almost forgot. There's one more thing we need to do. One more thing. Oh, I usually like to upgrade endurance and health side by side. Not a lot of people like to do that. Some people like endurance more. But I just think an equal kind of scaling to them is more beneficial.
So up here.
Right here there's a bunch of rats. For some reason they don't attack you. Here's a gray axe. Tons of strength needed, honestly, but it's what it looks like. I can't even wield it correctly, you know. What's my endurance like? Okay. Whoa. 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 Whoa, I'm getting fucking stunlocked by this motherfucker right now. I don't understand. What the fuck is with the aggressive AI? That AI was aggressive as fuck. I don't understand. We're just gonna stay with the poison for now. Because I don't want to use up my blooming moss. I don't know, the AI was just being really aggressive right there. I don't understand. It was stunlocking me. We only have two. Oh, damn it. Poison's not that bad. It's toxic you have to worry about. I want to lure this guy over here. Is he going to send all of them after me? It looks like probably not. So I'm just going to stay right here and do that. Oh, he can hit me now. Shit, I want to try and bring him over here. I want to kill this guy before I deal with those fucking rats. Because they're huge. Oh, they're empowered though, god damn it. Alright. Okay. We got this. Oh! Whoa! Oh, he's following really fucking close behind us. Well, that's all we needed to do over there anyway, so let's just get the fuck out of here. And go fight the gaping dragon. Isn't that the rat that puffed me up? Okay. So I was getting lost for a second. And what's interesting, I think, about this boss fight is that we can both summon Latrek and Solaire at the same time. I'm not going to summon either of them because the boss fight the boss's scale, their health, they scale the boss's health. So, they don't really do any damage to him. They just kind of die immediately, so there's really no point in doing it. Heavy crossbow and some crossbow bolts. So here we go. Here's Latrek. And here's Solaire. And I just gotta do some settings on my computer real quick. Let's go. So yeah, this is the Gaping Dragon. Actually not doing as much damage as I thought I would. If you leave the sorcerer up there alive, which they're called channelers, I just remembered. If you leave the channeler alive, he will empower the boss and increase the damage and aggressiveness by a lot, so just be careful. Cut off the tail and you get the Dragon King Great Axe. And he's dead. So there you go. Gaping Dragon, guys. Right fucking there. and you get a flurry of souls. At least in this point of the game, it's a flurry of souls after you kill him. To do with what you please. We're going to be leveling up and going to Blighttown right now. Because fuck it, why not? I want to try to at least get to the first bonfire in Blighttown. I'm actually purposefully handicapping myself right now. Normally I've already killed the certain enemy that you need to kindle the bonfire more, but I have not this time because of this playthrough, you motherfuckers. We want 20 strength and 20 dexterity, but we want 20 dexterity for a certain weapon. It's another katana, so it's just it's a special katana, has a special moveset. It's nice. Oh, the Dragon King Grey Axe requires 50 strength to use and has no scaling. But it does have a strong attack, which is an AoE, which is area attack. Alright, let's see what he has. We're gonna... I like never get a bottomless box anyway, because there's no, because the equipment load is only what you have equipped in these slots, slots right here. Rings don't count. In Dark Souls 2 they do, but in Dark Souls 1 they don't count. So we're just gonna slide on down here, and we're gonna do the old the old ladder trick, making him fall off, you know? It's easier than fighting them. There we go. Just make him fall off, and then we get a couple hundred souls. 500, damn. You don't have to fight these guys or do this, you can just run past them if you're good enough, but honestly at this point in the game, I usually just make them fall. It's easier than worrying about them. I think we're gonna want to equip this shield. Oh, we don't. Okay. Alright, so we don't have the sorcerer catalyst now, but we have resistance to poison, which is important here. It is important because there's a lot of poison shit going on. Lure him to follow us. Okay. Come on. Come on, big fatty. Come on, big guy. Oh, don't get stuck on that. Oh, you got stuck. Oh, okay, you're good. There we go. It's just little things that help your stress be lower in this game than it otherwise would be. I really should have, do not do much damage to these guys. Ooh! Ha! can backstab these guys, so if you want to try that, I'm just going to equip these. Because there's some blow dart snipers. There's a blow dart sniper right there. Take him out right now. And these guys don't respawn. The blow dart snipers don't respawn, so once you kill them, you don't have to worry about them again. I would suggest not walking on this path, because I think it moves while you walk on it, so you can just simply go around. But there is an enemy here, so just when these guys are doing charging up, don't just move out of the way, roll out of the way, whatever you gotta do, just don't let them get you with that, because they will fuck your day up. We're actually going to be jumping, and I fucked it up. Well, we're not going to kill all those enemies again. We're just going to run past them and keep jumping. Because there's a certain platform I want to get to. I just messed it up. Keep going. I'm mildly salty. I'm lightly salted about that right now. While this guy's roaring, we're gonna just run past him. This guy's not roaring, so... just gonna skirt around these guys. Oh, we made it. Nice. This is the Ayato. The Ayato, or whatever. It's almost equivalent to the Uchikatana. The Uchikatana has better scaling, at plus 15. But it has, it has the same kind of normal, just up and down, just weak attacks, but the strong attack is replaced by this nice slash. When you two-hand it, you get this. Yeah, really cool slash. It's really nice for ninja kind of builds and want to be really kind of like cool or like samurai. Much better than just that stupid little cut there. Okay. Oh, they dropped something. Oh, piece of shit. Okay, cool. So we made it back. Let's get our vitality. I'm not a Blighttown expert, guys, so I'm just warning you, I'm not an expert on Blighttown. I rarely ever go even, like, go this way. I usually skip this way, because we could skip it even without the master key, but, like, I'm just saying I rarely ever go this way. Do we have to go this way? So I don't exactly remember where to go. I have a general idea we need to somehow get down to the ground level, but I don't exactly remember how to get down there without dying. Okay. I'm just gonna do this because that little platform can fuck up your camera and then just fuck up the way that you're walking. Very useful, more blooming purple moss clumps. There's an item over there. These little bridges move. When you're walking on them. Sometimes you'll go with the bridge, and other times you will not. So just be mindful of that. Oh, they usually give me enough time to react, so, and I have a terrible reaction time, so I think that you guys will be fine with them. These are fire-breathing dogs, so just be careful when you're fighting them. If there's more than one, they can stunlock you. And just fuck you up. Got humanity here. Whoa, 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 whoa. This, I believe, leads to nowhere. So, it looks like we gotta go the other way. Back across the bridge. Curiously walking across this bridge. I'm just gonna rest at the bonfire again, and then just seeing how much we need to level up, that sort of thing. All that good shit. I'm just gonna go up here. I really want to get the shadow set. This shadow garb looks really nice. It's pretty much ninja armor. Around here. Oh shit, I didn't see that. I think... Oh, you see? They just fuck your day up. Oh. Oh. God damn it. Okay. Well, it's not that bad. We're not that far away. Remember that breaks. We're back over here, so if you want to get back out of Blighttown, this is where you go. Which, honestly, I wouldn't blame you if you just want to skip this. If you would just want to be like, fuck this shit. I don't blame you. I'm not going to call you like, oh, you're just not good enough. Honestly, I don't blame you if you don't want to go here. Especially on console where the FPS drops to fucking like zero. You have to kind of go over, make it maneuver over here. And there you go, the shadow set. I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. It has really good poison resistance, so it's really good for Blighttown. Here you go. Basically, you look like a fucking ninja. The poison resistance is really good, but, change it now. I think it's light enough to have that. No. Okay, so we need to take this off. We can fast roll. Okay. Now, if we just kind of carefully come over here. It's the soul of a proud knight. Right here. Very carefully. Another soul of a proud knight. Can't come over here, so we gotta... No platform below, so we have to kind of go over here. This dog is just... These dogs are going crazy. Oh fuck, it's one of them and a dog. Oh, okay, we just got him. We just got him with some phantom damage. That's good, that's good. We want to go kill that Blowdar sniper because he's being a bitch. But, I forget exactly how to get over there. Must be somewhere here. Oh yeah, there's that fucking thing. I don't... I'm gonna try and go from behind and kill it. Well, this guy to come back down here. Oh, I was trying to knock him off, but killing him was fine too. There's a ladder here. I don't really like that. We might have to go down there though. I think we do. Alright. What's this guy come? Oh, I guess he's not coming up. What the fuck? Actually knock him off just by tapping B a lot while on the ladder. Oh, crap. Okay. Actually, there's another guy who just hopped down. Could have been that. Oh! No, are you fucking kidding me right now? He just completely knocked me off. actually don't need to go this way. Yup, just fucking spit fire immediately at me. I think I just fucked myself. Yep. That's why you don't just run through shit like that when you don't know where you're going. See, I got mad and I just did that without thinking. God. Enough with the stun locking. Jesus Christ. This is why we need the fucking wolf ring. Try not to get mad right now, so. Oh, well, it turns out that we just fucking went in a loop and probably fucked ourselves a little. Sorry if I'm really quiet right here. I'm just trying to figure out where I'm going, as I haven't played Light Town in a while. I think we have to go down this ladder here. It's fucking blade, motherfucker. Piece of shit. Over here, there's an important item. Okay. The Eagle Shield. It used, when the game first came out, it used to block 100% physical damage, but it only blocks 95 now. Which kind of sucks, but it's because it was overpowered since people could get that shield so easily. Where we're going. There's an enemy right there. Do we go down there? Like we might be, but I don't know. I don't want to jump down there and die. Oh, there's a ladder here. Cool. Okay. Shit, he fucked me up? How did that happen? Okay, so we got this fucking thing right here. I think we might have Let's see how much damage a firebomb does. Just got to aim that. Fucking nothing. Okay, so. See if we can get behind him. It's a barbarian here. This guy, because he's gonna just run up behind me anyway. We have to kill him anyway. And Jesus Christ, this guy followed me. I didn't think that he would do that. Oh shit. We gotta get the fuck out of here. Oh, I think I know where I am. Okay, I think I know where I am. I think we're almost out of here. Oh shit. He fucking followed me, fucking mosquito ass motherfuckers. Get the fuck out of my way. I think he's still coming after me, I can't tell. No, oh shit. Okay, you dirty ass cunts. Alright, I know exactly where I am now. Alright. Oh, I gotta get a certain ring before we came here. Fuck, it's a ring that makes it so that you don't go slow in this pool in the water here, poison. Oh, we lit the bonfires. Checkpoints in disguise. We made it out of that part of Blighttown, but we're still in Blighttown, so. Interesting treasure right here. So, a lot of people wonder where the gaping dragon came from. I think, personally, because I've seen this, this hole here lines up almost perfectly. With where the gaping dragon comes out. So I'm thinking that he was down here. Somewhere in this hole. And he was waiting for something. Or he was sleeping, doing something. Personally, I think he was warped by the poison that's in Blighttown. It didn't damage him, but it just kind of warped him, maybe? It's just my theory. Okay, we want to... can level up twice. Yes. Good. Resistance to me is pretty much useless. So, yeah. Our hollowing. And Kindle. Excuse me. Kindle this bonfire. So we're human now and we're gonna get invaded once again. Bye. a certain special character. Man-Eater Mildred, hell yeah. I'm gonna try. It's a big word there. Big asterisk next to it. Try to parry this bitch. Oh, there goes half your health, Mildred. I'm sorry. Oh, those fucking mosquitoes are coming here. Oops. You're almost dead. Oh! Don't let me die now. There you go, bitch. That's what you get. So, I believe we got the cleaver. The butcher's knife, I'm sorry. If we two-hand it, we can use it. Use it a lot of stamina. We get this cool execution kind of thing. It does a lot of damage, not as much as our Uchikatana right now, because we're just skilled in that. So... We have a couple things to do before we go and kill Kellogg's over there. Her name's actually Quaylog, but I like to call her, and a lot of the people in the Souls community like to call her Kellogg's. You know, just for fun, you know. Just for fun. Alright, I'm gonna go and try and get a certain ring. Special ring. It's a really good ring. It's like one of my favorite rings ever. Series. Not that we're going to be using it for the full playthrough, but it is just really useful to have. These are the slugs I was talking about before that drop the shards. It's a rare chance, so you really got to have your item discovery up, or else you're going to be there for a long time. We got an extra pyromancer set. We started off as a pyromancer, right? Yeah, so we already had got it. Not even really bothering healing the poison, because we're just gonna get poisoned again. Kind of difficult to see because I have the brightness kind of down. Now it kind of looks like we're in a cave, which we semi are. It's kind of in a cave, and I'll show you in a second why I pointed that out. It looks like we're in a cave. Because we're actually outside. Ooh, green titanite shards, that's a lot. They drop a lot of green titanite shards when they do drop green titanite shards, but they usually only drop one large titanite shard. Which we need large titanite shards. Thought I saw something. I tried so hard, but in the end, it doesn't even matter. I believe there's a large titanite shard. Oh shit, I forgot about this guy. Oh, large titanite shard, hell yeah. And another one. Good. So immediately when we got here, we can start upgrading our katana further. Oh shit. I mean, later you're going to be able to buy them, but it is going to be quite expensive. They are going to be quite expensive, so. More Titanite Shards, hell yeah. This guy's already dead? Yeah, okay, yeah, I remember. I just couldn't see where we were. Well, his body's fucking spazzing out. These slugs, weirdly enough, can do a lot of damage, so just be careful. Especially if you're running low health. We have a lot of large Titanite Shards now. This can get us up to plus 6, I say, or 7. We want to get to plus 10. Right here is the server. The sever, whatever you want to call it. It's a curved greatsword. I can't use it right now, but I can use it with two hands, I believe. Yep. So, it's a curved greatsword. They're kind of an oddity to see, especially online, in Dark Souls 1. I know in Dark Souls 2, the Murakumo is semi-popular, especially after this guy Praise the Sun. He makes very good videos of amazing weapon guides and stuff. He made a weapon guide to the Murakumo, and it kind of exploded in popularity because nobody could really figure out exactly how to use this weapon. That weapon. Pretty much what you had to do is that you had to bait into parries, and then you could speed super parry, because that weapon had a really fast parry animation after specific attacks. More green Titanite Shards. So yeah, if you're looking for a magic weapon, this is the place to farm for these things. Got a plank shield. We open up this chest. We got Twin Humanities. And this chest is basically here to make it so that you don't try and go through here. And we're going to be going down here later in the Great Hollow. But we need to get the Lord Vessel first. Or else we're going to... Personally, I cannot get back up. So we're going to be trapped there if we go down without it. Except I have Homeward Bones, so it's long. Okay. Okay, we made it. The Chloranthi ring. Chikatana. And it boosts your stamina recovery speed. And now, guys, I apologize. I have to end the episode here. And I'll see you guys next time. See you guys later.